Hey, 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 welcome to Jim and Tay Have Their Say.
That's good.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm feeling better since we've been getting productive.
Yeah, it's been a strange week.
This today felt like Saturday all day long.
Yeah.
It's a Friday when we're shooting this, and it feels like Saturday, like nothing's happening.
Totally different.
It's a very different vibe. None of the days feel the same because we're on strike. It's summertime, and there's all these things that just kind of throw the regular schedule out. And
don't I know it?
You do. You know it very well. I wanted to talk to you about this phenomenon that happens a lot, where if you're a person like me and you're always putting out content or you're always trying to contact people and, you know, make things happen, and because that's part of your business, do you ever get in a state where you are expecting a lot of answers that aren't coming from people, either people you texted or people you wrote to or people you called, and they're just not, for some reason, not responding? What do you do about it?
Yeah, what do you do about it? I mean, noted, you note it. You know, some people are very quick to respond to communications. Mm. I found, you know, that the excuse of I'm busy or I was busy is not actually one, because I feel like the busier people that I know actually respond really quickly to communications. I know that I've been guilty of it myself before, but I try to answer, I mean, even on Instagram messages that come in, like just to be answer, because I think communication is such a huge part of life and making someone feel heard and understood and important. And I've been on the other side of, yeah, not having communications answered ever or really long, and doesn't make you feel good.
Yeah, you definitely don't feel important.
No, you feel very unimportant.
Yeah, it's interesting because I feel the same way. And when you get a text, you have that moment of thought, sometimes I do anyway, where you go, I don't actually have to handle this right now. I don't actually have to respond to this right now because that person's not here. I'm not even sure when they wrote this text. And it's not like a phone call or coming up to someone on the street and saying, hey, I wanted to know if you would go with me to that thing, right? You would never just turn your back and leave or stand there silently for 15 minutes or a day or a month and a half. You would feel compelled to say, oh, you know, I don't know the answer to that right now, but I'll check my calendar. Or you'd say, oh, yeah, I've been thinking about that and I'm not sure I want to go. And you would have a communication, which would accomplish something.
Yeah, what I'm realizing now is I think it has to do with one's ability to start, change, and stop something, to control something. Because it's true, nowadays, we will check our phone when we're in the middle of something, which probably is a little bit of, maybe we shouldn't, right? We're
sometimes,
in the middle of something. We shouldn't necessarily stop what we're doing. We check our phone, we see a message, then, oh, I won't answer this now because I'm in the middle of this. But I'm the one who just added that confusion into this scenario here.
That's right. You started it.
Yeah, exactly. And then now my attention's there and there. I'm not even as able to do the thing I was doing in the first place as well, because now I've got my attention spread. Maybe I'll forget about answering that text message. I usually end up going at the end of the day and I'm like, okay, is there anyone I forgot to answer today?
That's nice.
Yeah.
I do this a lot. Do you do this where you'll look for a text or you'll check your email because you're kind of hungry for good news? It's almost like a form of entertainment.
Uh-huh.
It could be good news on any level. It could be, you know, something happened to the family or a job offer,
yep,
or something intriguing or interesting. And it's almost like you're consuming it because you need to feel a little bit better, self-gratifying. You know, I know I checked my text messages 5 minutes ago, but I'm going to check them again because I just feel like I need a little input from something that might be intriguing or interesting or actually...
But you're trying to manifest something.
Yeah,
is that what
you're
you
like
mean?
Hoping
not,
for
it's
it.
Not
it's
something
like you're
that,
hoping for it.
Oh, yeah, yes, for sure I've done that. Like, I'm going to check my email because probably my agents emailed me. And then sometimes, yes, but usually those things come when you're not expecting them,
that's
I
right.
find.
Yeah,
it's
that's right.
It's more, I do think the actual answer to this problem is to not let it worry you. If someone's not getting back to you, don't worry about it. And just keep communicating. And, you know, I'm going to promise to all of you that I'm going to be better even at communicating. And I'm sure you would say the same.
I can't promise that. I'll definitely try. Like I usually respond to comments on YouTube and social. It's hard because I get a lot more than I used to. But I can at least try to do that.
Yeah, exactly. I think it is important. We have so many more ways to be in communication with one another. I think that is what makes the world go round. So don't stop communicating. Always keep communicating and
keep the conversation going.
Yeah.
Not necessarily AI conversation either, because you can tell the difference.
Not necessarily. 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 Necessarily.
Oh my God.
Necessarily. Oh.
Thanks for watching.
Okay, bye.